Your phones. When it's time for an update, your phone start acting crazy. Come on, I need y'all to hear this. This is prophetic. When it's time for an update, the phone act crazy. And so, the devil starts acting crazy when he know you about to be updated. When there's an update that's about to take place, because see, an update just don't happen. You get notified that there's a new version of what you already have. You get a notification that tells you that either you can update now or remind me later. And see, what God is saying to some of you, I've got a new version of you. I've got a new version of you. Will you update or will you wait till later? Because the more you wait to update, the crazier the phone acts. You don't get the newest of newest. You have the same phone somebody else has, but when you look, why my phone don't look like that? Oh, I got an update. You didn't update yet. And you want the update, but you got an update. God is saying, let me give you the new version of you. Let me update you. Let me take you higher. And he talked about it today. He talked about how we gotta see God, but sometimes we gotta take off the scales. It's okay, find a distraction. Let's get it on out of the way. The devil is defeated. God is still glorified. Amen. See how God worked? You see how quick that was? You see how quick that was? Y'all see how quick that was? Y'all see how quick God works? We allow little stuff to distract us when we have the power to speak to the distraction and tell it to go. Now y'all see how God just gave y'all an example of how y'all supposed to live y'all life? Just that quick. Here we are talking about an update. And we get ready to go into an upgraded position. An update, new beginnings is gone. And the devil, let me distract what she's trying to say. Not.
No.
You can't distract what God has already destined. You can't destroy what God has already purposed. You can't remove what God has already finished. It is what it is. Learn how to upgrade. And that means upgrading your mind. Recognizing the distraction and speaking against it. Nobody moved. Nobody did anything. It just stopped. I said, find out where it at and remove it. Before pastor could go, before they get anything. It, boom, there you go. God says, I have the power to relinquish the enemy's power. But we got to learn how to speak it. We got to learn how to have that power. And the only way to have that power is if you got Jesus. I don't know about you, but I'm ready for the upgrade. I've been mashed mine. Ain't no remind me later. Upgrade now. I don't care how long it takes. Because a lot of us don't like to update and upgrade the phone because it takes so long to upgrade. But you got to understand, to get to the new version and get to the perfect you, there's a process. It might take long, but here it is. Once it's finished, I'm upgrading. We like to remind me later. That ain't going to take too long. I ain't going to be able to use my phone. I got to put it on Wi-Fi. I got to wait till it gets finished. Everything. reminding yourself later, hey, I'm praying right now. Learn how to wait for the process to be over with. Upgrade me, Jesus. Upgrade me, Jesus. I'm ready for the new me. While you're standing, turn with me to Philippians chapter 4. We're going to go through. This might be a teach word, it might be a preach word, it might be a two sentences. I don't know what it's going to be, but go with me to Philippians 4, verse 13. Philippians chapter 4, verse 13. And it says, I can do all things through Christ, which strengthens me. Now skip on down to the 19th verse. And it says, but my God shall supply all your needs according to his riches in glory by Christ Jesus. And if I would use for a topic, it would be, you need Jesus. You need Jesus. Father, in the mighty name of Jesus, we need you. We need you, Jesus. Father, and we need you to shift us and to change us, to upgrade us, to recognize exactly who you are and what you're capable of doing. Father, as I come your vessel, Father, I die that you may rise up in me, God. I decrease that you may increase, God, that you may consume me with your word. God, I speak only what you say speak, so give me the words to speak, Father. God, allow your words, God, to be like rivers of living water that flows. God, allow the prophet in me to arise now, that I may give the people the food that they need, God, that it may go into their bellies, oh God, and give them the nourishment that they need to upgrade in you. Father, I'm speaking that this word, God, will not fall on deaf ears, God, but ears that are open, a heart that is willing to receive, and a mind that may be able to comprehend it now. Give us understanding and wisdom and knowledge of your word. Father, I know you're going to do it. You've already done it. And we praise you and we give your name all the glory and the honor now. In Jesus Christ's name, amen, amen. It is so. You may take your seat. And again, the topic is you need Jesus. We all know we need Jesus, right? We all know every day we cannot live without having Jesus. We all know that this life that we live is predicated off of Jesus. Everything we do is about Jesus. It's about God. Everything, life, waking up, all of it is about God. But we sometimes get to the place where we tend to forget that we need Jesus. Can I be honest? We forget that we need Jesus sometimes. And we begin to move and think and breathe and do things we feel like on our own. We feel like it's all us. We're doing it. Everything that's taking place in my life, I'm the one that's dictating it. I'm the one that makes things happen. I go to work. I pay my bills. I do this. I go home. I clean. I cook. I do everything. But we forget that we need Jesus and that Jesus is doing it all. So I'm sitting in the house one day and God began to speak to me. And then Pastor and I was out. And I was sitting, we were in the car, waiting on someone to meet us. And God told me, God said, turn to Philippians 4. And I began to read from the first verse on down. And I stopped at the 13th verse. And it says, I can do all things through Christ, which strengthens me. And when you read that, you begin to think, I can do this. Because it says, I can do. And then we go and we say, well, I can do it. I can do it. I can do it. I can do all things through Christ, which strengthens me. I can do it. So when I do it, I did it. And all of this, and God began to speak to me, and God says, because I was thinking and I was praying about some stuff, and I was like, God, I need you to come through on some different things. I want you to show up on this area. We're looking for a building. We're doing this and doing that. God, I need you to do this. And God began to speak. So I just read the scripture, and I was like, yes. God, thank you for the confirmation. I can do all things through you. I can do it. And then God says, but I need you to break it down. And God said, read it again. And I read it again. And I read it one more time. And the word through stepped out to me. It was like in bold letters that time I read it. And I went to my phone and I pulled up the dictionary. And I said, what does through mean? And through means by way of or within. By way of or within. So God began to speak to me, and God says, we as people, we have to understand that we can do all things through Christ that strengthens us. We can do all things by way of Christ that strengthens us. We can do all things within Christ that strengthens us. So God is saying, if I can do all things, there is nothing that I can't do if I have him within me. So when we quote the scripture, I can do all things through Christ that strengthens me, a lot of us quote the scripture and we don't have him within. No, it ain't. It's going to work out for me because I can do all things through Christ that strengthens me. But the through means within, by way of Jesus. If I was to use an example and I was to say I got to the shore by the ship, I was within the ship that took me to the shore. There is no way that I'm going to get to the shore if I wasn't on the ship. So we're quoting these scriptures, and we have different things that go on in our life, but we got to understand when we read the scripture, we got to do what the scripture says, because the scripture don't tell us to do something. It just says, I can do all things through Christ that strengthens me. But the scripture is really telling you, you only going to be able to do all things if you have Jesus within you. All things ain't happening for everybody if they don't have Jesus. That's why the topic said, you need Jesus. We live this life day after day, month after month, year after year, and we're declaring every day, I can do all things. But then when the all things are not done, and there are some things, it's because God will allow you to go but so far that you ain't got it. All things mean everything, not some things, not part of things, but all things I can do if I got Jesus. So I begin to read a little bit more. God said, 19, read it. But my God shall supply all. Come on now, all. We back at this again. All. My God shall supply all my needs according to his riches in glory. Really? And we always stop at glory, ain't it? But we don't never say, by Christ Jesus. Isn't that what the scripture says? But my God shall supply all of my needs according to his riches in glory. By Christ Jesus. So, I said, dog. God, I don't never say by Christ Jesus. I always stop at the glory. Because it sounds good. It makes me feel good. It gives me confidence. It makes me have faith. It makes me believe in my God. But what's the purpose of believing if you ain't doing? The Bible says not only be a hearer, but a doer of the word. So, but my God shall supply all of my needs according to his riches in glory by Christ Jesus. I said, by. I saw that bold letters. By means, as mean of conveyance. By means that I can only get by you is if I walk past you. By means that by way of something, I got this business by way of finances.
Come on, yes, Lord.
I got a new car by way of finance. I got my husband by way of relationship. But my God shall supply all of my needs by way of his son, Jesus.
Yeah, come on, Lord.
So, when we are speaking and we're going through different things in our life and we say, but my God shall supply all of my needs according to his riches and glory. But how you getting by that though? You need Jesus. You need Jesus. I don't care what your job pay you. I don't care what your job pay you. You can make a six-figure salary yearly. But it's by way of God that you got it. Because the needs are supplied by way of Jesus. And so many of us don't understand that a lot of us, that when we don't have a job, it looks like all our needs being met. My husband and I went through that. Didn't work for almost 3 years. Every bill in the house was paid. Everything that we needed done, food, clothes, everything was supplied by way of Jesus. God wanted to show us that we like to quote these things, but when all of our needs are not supplied, it's because you ain't got Jesus. Because the all comes by way of Jesus. The all comes through and within Jesus. We got to make sure that when we are in the word of God, that we don't forget Jesus. We tend to live the limit thinking it's us and God. It's just me and God. Guess what? You need Jesus. Because he said that you can't go to the Father unless you go. Through who? Jesus. The access to the Father comes through Jesus. And how do we get Jesus? Good question. I know somebody just asked me that. I heard you. Because I thought I had him. I thought I had Jesus. I thought me and Jesus was doing it up. I thought me and Jesus was living it out. I thought me and Jesus had this thing on lock. Me and my buddy. But we walk around and we operate every day without the Spirit. Your Jesus is the Spirit that abides on the inside of you, that tells you what to do, how to do it, when to do it, what to say, how to act, how to move, how to dress, how to do. The Spirit is what guides us. But if you don't have the Spirit, you don't have Jesus. So it's okay that if something happens to me throughout the day and somebody make me mad, I get the thought of I want to tell them off. But if you want to tell them off, the Spirit of God, of Jesus, is not in you, because the Spirit will immediately dictate how you're supposed to respond. And we want Jesus to supply all of our needs, but if you ain't got him, he can't do it, because he lives within. We're living a life without Jesus, and a life without Jesus is meaningless. A life without Jesus is death. You're listening. Because the only way that you can upgrade is if you got Jesus. The only way you're going to be able to see is if you have Jesus. You can ask for the scales to be removed day in and day out, but the scales only come off when you have the eyes of Jesus. How do we go higher? We got to have Jesus. The Bible tells us that I wish above all things that you be in good health and prosper, even as your soul prosper. Who is the I that wishes this? It's Jesus. And the only way that we can prosper and get to the next level is if we have Jesus. The only way that we're going to shift and go to where God needs us to go is if we have Jesus. We cannot be in a house and worship and praise in this house and not have Jesus. Who are we worshiping? Who are we praising to? We come in the house and we say, "Hail Jesus, glory to our Father, thank you, Lord." But we leave out of here and live a hellish life. That shows us we don't have Jesus. And so when you're looking for all things to be taken care of, it can't be because you don't have Jesus. I know this ain't the word that you're looking to hear. You're looking to hear, "Yes, we get ready to go to the next level." You're looking for a hollering and hooping. God said, "No, tell them they need Jesus." Because he's supplying all of your needs. You can quote the scripture all you want to. It don't mean nothing to quote a scripture. It doesn't mean anything when it says that by his stripes I am healed. Isn't that what the word said? By his stripes I am healed. By. Come on now. By way of Jesus, I am healed. So when you're sick in your body, with y'all all the time. Soon as we feel a little something, oh God, by God, I can't be sick, God. I can't, no Lord, because you said by your stripes. But you ain't got by. You ain't got by. Yet the stripes are there for you, but you don't have by. Because by means by way of. By way of Jesus is how you're healed, by his stripes. He was bruised. He was beaten for you, but you can't have him if you don't receive him. Luke 18 and 27 says, he replied, what is impossible for people is possible with God. What is impossible for people is possible for God. So if all things are possible, because we like to say this, all things are possible because the word says I'm possible. That ain't in the Bible. But it's good that you wrote that down. That is not how it's possible. Just because it say I'm possible. There's a cartoon that say that too, ain't it? Kim Possible. See how we can just use that word however we want to? But if you don't have the possible. Because it says, what is impossible to man is possible to God. How do I get God to do the possible? By way of Jesus. And I'm praying for a day that we as people can take out the time to really get Jesus. Because we're living every day thinking we got him. This lady asked me my inbox one day. She said, how is it that people can believe that God is a healer, and they believe it because they believe in God, but they're not healed? How is it that I read my word and I see what the word says, and the word tells us that we have the power of life and death in our tongue, and I can speak this over my life and it don't happen? Does anybody have those questions sometimes? Why is it that when I go to the house of God and the word comes forth, it empowers me and it gets me hyped up? But when I have certain situations in my life, they don't work out the way that I want it to work out. God said, and I inboxed her back, and I said, do you have Jesus? Do you have Jesus? Because everything that you said was, I read the word, I speak what it says, I go to church, I listen to the preacher or the pastor, whoever's up, but I never heard you say that you had Jesus.
by Jesus is how Jesus can work it out. He says in John 15, verse 7, if ye abide in me, and I in you, you can ask what you will, and I'll do it. If you abide through me, by way of me, within me, and I in you, you can ask me what you want and I will do it. The question is, we do everything else except have Jesus. I was baptized in the Holy Spirit. A lot of people don't understand that to be filled with the Holy Spirit, the evidence is the speaking in tongues. To be filled. So you may say, well, I know I'm filled with Jesus. I got the Spirit. But I ain't spoke. Keep trying. You will be filled. I'm not saying that God is not going to speak to you, because he speaks to you about you. That's what he does. He tells you about you. When you hear him, he's going to speak to you about you, because he's trying to get you together. But when you have the Holy Spirit is when the gifts will stir up in you and you can help somebody else. But until you get you, there's no way that you can help somebody else, because the Spirit is what guides you to other people to do what needs to be done. Until you have the Spirit, which is Jesus, is when God will only speak to you about you. Because he's trying to fill you. He's trying to make all things possible for you. He's trying to make it to where there is nothing that you ask him for that you can't get. Some of y'all need to start tearing. Oh, Lord, she's going back to the old church. That's how you got your deliverance. That's how you got your healing. That's how you got filled. When you lay down and spent time with God. But we can't get no Jesus because we're not trying to get a relationship with Jesus. We're just trying to get the things that Jesus has and has already ordained and assigned for us to have. But you can't get it unless you got him. You need Jesus. Who got Jesus? I know I shouldn't have asked that question. I know I shouldn't have. Because if you didn't have him, you should have been hollering and screaming and declaring that you're going to get him. The only way we can be upgraded is if we have the upgrader. You can't just upgrade without the version sent to you. You can't just go in your phone and find an upgrade and hold on, let me find this thing, see if I can upgrade. No, that is not how, it has to be sent to you before you can upgrade. You can't go on your phone and search for an upgrade. If you do and you go in the store and you find an upgrade, it won't fit you. It won't be the upgrade that's designed for your phone. You'll be upgrading into something else that's not for you and it won't fit. But to get to the real design of who you are, you need the upgrader, which is Jesus. We speak all the time, I want to go higher. I want to see you. I want these scales to come off. I want you to take off the weight. I want you to do this, God. Shift me. Change me. Let me die. God, you live. But we don't take on the very person that does that thing. We don't take on the very spirit that does that for us. It's time for us to get Jesus. There's no way around it. There's no way around it. There's no way over it, under it, on the side of it. You got to go through Jesus. Everything you're seeking out in life, you're going to get it through Jesus. invisible. Everything else will fade away. But when all of that fade away and you don't have Jesus, guess what you're going to do? Fade away. You need Jesus. In the time that we're living in now, in the mess that's going on in this world, we need Jesus. It's okay to preach other stuff. It's okay to tell people they can have this and they can have that and God is going to make a way out of nowhere. But don't lie to the people. God is going to make a way out of nowhere as long as you got Jesus.
All. That's the key word. All.
all. I want all, God. Then you need Jesus. I want all of it to be supplied. You need Jesus. I want all of it to be possible. You need Jesus. I want all sickness and diseases washed away. Then you need Jesus. I don't want to have to struggle. I don't want to have to go through. I don't want to have to be burdened down. You need Jesus. Because he know how to handle struggle. He know how to suffer. He's done it before. He's done it before. So if you've got Jesus, when the suffering and the struggle come, he will bring about peace. And you won't have to worry about what you got going on and how you suffering and how you struggling and how you going through and how this issue came up and that issue. I've got Jesus. He's going to handle all of that because he said all things are possible to them that believe in me. Is there anybody who wants Jesus? Is there anybody who wants Jesus? Is there anybody who's willing to give up for Jesus? So for now on, when you text me and ask me questions, I'm going to say you got Jesus.
Sure.
Do you have Jesus? I know you need somebody to talk to sometimes. I know you be going through. I know you be needing. But do you have Jesus though? Do you really have him? I speak in tongues. I know I'm filled. You can speak in old tongues and need to be refilled. Amen?
Amen.
I don't care how much you speak. I don't care how much you cry out. It's not enough. It's not enough. It's not enough. We get complacent with the old cry, with the old tongues, with the old praise. Just like we were saying, it's time to upgrade, but you gotta have Jesus. You know how you go and you let people pray, certain people pray, and they start off with the same prayer all the time. They pray the same thing all the time. They pray the same way all the time. It's because they ain't went nowhere from that place. They got to that place. They ain't moved nowhere else. They stuck right there because they have not been seeking more of Jesus. Father God, in the name of Jesus, Father, we thank you, God, for upgrade your prayer. Shift the way you seek after God. Spend more time with Jesus. The more time you spend with Jesus is the more you will get of Jesus. We don't spend enough time with Jesus. And we have so many questions and so many, I don't know what's going on. Seek Jesus. You won't have all those problems. He'll give you the answer. He will give you the answer. I don't know if y'all noticed it, but I ain't playing no more. I'm not playing. I want Jesus. I don't care about that other stuff. Because of the time that we're living in now, that other stuff ain't gonna be able to keep you. that other stuff is not going to be able to keep you. That other stuff is not going to protect you. I don't know why I feel like this. But if you don't have Jesus, you are living a dead end life. And it is imperative that we get Jesus. I'm so serious about my life with Jesus. I don't care about nothing else. I don't care who don't like me. I don't care who talk about me. I don't care who leave me. All I care about is Jesus. That's all I care about. That's all I want. All I want is Jesus. Because when everybody else leave, you better believe Jesus will never leave you nor forsake you. When everything else fails, God never fails. All I want is Jesus. Every trial, every tribulation that I've gone through, I don't care. Jesus has always been there to keep me at peace. Jesus has always been there to comfort me and to hold me when I felt like crying and giving up. Jesus stepped in and said, "You can't stop. I'm here."
Yes, Lord. Thank you, Jesus.
That's why. All I want is Jesus. Everybody else, can you pray for me? I got this going on. Can you pray for me? I got that going on. I'm sick in my body. I got this and I got that. And I'm doing this and I'm doing that. And God, I just need God to do something for me. Can you pray for me? And I'm like, Lord, you got me praying for so many people. I'm only one little person. One little person, God. And you got me praying for all these people. So what if I pray for somebody? And I'm being real. And the same sickness they got, they get delivered and I get it. What if what is on somebody attaches to me? I'm out here putting my life on the line. God said, your life is not your life. When you gave your life to me, I gave you mine. I gave you Jesus. And when I gave you Jesus, you are healed by his stripes. When I gave you Jesus, nothing could attach to you because I gave you Jesus, because you gave me you. So when I walk around day after day and I hear about people catching colds, and there's a little common stuff, colds and flu and all this stuff, and I'm like, I'm looking at my house and I'm like, Lord, you don't get sick like that. He said, because you got Jesus.
Yes, the Lord.
I can't tell you the last time I was sick in my body. I can't tell you the last time when I ain't had food on my table. Never. I can't tell you the last time when I didn't have. Never. I've always had, because I always had Jesus. And then they look at my life.
Yes, the Lord.
And they look at my life and they say, how she got what she got. How she live, how she live. How she walk around so happy and joyous every day. Happy, y'all don't even know what's going on in my life.
Come on.
Happy, y'all don't even know what I got going on. look at me, you see somebody always joyous and happy. You don't even know the half. But you know why when you see that person? It's because the half of that don't even matter. I've got Jesus. I've got Jesus. After all the things that I've gone through, I've still got Jesus. I still got Jesus. He's never failed me. I see the all. I see the all. Even in abuse, being young, I still saw the all.
Jesus.
Even being lied on, I still see the all. Even being abused and talked about, I still see the all. Because I've got all. Because I've got Jesus. I'm telling you about me now. Because I can tell you that you need Jesus. But it's up to you to get him. But I'm telling you, I got him. And because I got him, it's why I'm here. I could have been dead a long time ago.
Come on now.
So many car accidents. So many things that happened to me. But I'm still here because I got Jesus. We don't understand that a lot of the things we go through in our life and some of the things we put ourselves in those situations. And we come out and we're kept is because you're chosen by Jesus.
Yes, Lord.
You're chosen by Jesus.
Yes, Lord. Thank you, Lord.
And being chosen by Jesus should make you want Jesus.
Yes, it should.
Thank you, Jesus.
Lord.
So if I seem odd or strange, and I seem different, and I seem like I ain't playing no more, and I'm not playing with you, it's because I'm not playing with Jesus. And because I'm not playing with Jesus, it's the reason why I won't play with you. And when I see that you need to be shifted and you need to be changed, if I jerk you up a little bit, don't get mad. Just love on Jesus. I was told you will make people run from you. You will make people leave you. How you act. I don't care. Because if they love Jesus, they love me too. If they want Jesus, they don't understand why I do what I do. They don't understand why I live the way I live. They don't understand why I talk the way I talk. And if they're for me, they'll stay anyway. If they're not, they'll leave. Because they really don't want Jesus. Because all I'm going to give you is Jesus. So if you are here and you want Jesus, and you know you need an upgrade. You know you need to seek him more. You know that you need to take your relationship higher. You know that there's more that you need to do to get him. And you know that you got things going on in your life. And you want the all. Come to the altar so you can get Jesus.